So we've now have two statistically significant phase three studies supporting the approval of our drug. And in those studies, we have found our product to be well tolerated.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Dr. Seth Lederman. He is the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals. And Dr. Lederman, welcome. Good to see you again.
Great to see you, Steve. Thank you for having me on.
Yeah, so the company had opportunity to present some data at a major conference in Rome around TNX-102 SL. So I'll let you pick it up from there. This is a pretty big scientific conference.
Sure. Well, TNX-102 SL is our new drug in development for fibromyalgia. And we expect to file the new drug application for TNX-102 SL to FDA in October of this year. So it's very exciting for Tonix to be at the point of imminently filing our new drug application. There are not many biotech companies that get all the way from an idea to a product that's on the verge of being filed for approval. So, in that vein, our product, TNX-102 SL, is a novel and proprietary formulation of cyclobenzaprine, and it's designed to be taken at bedtime. And for that reason, we had to come up with a new formulation that was engineered to improve the speed of uptake and also, very importantly, to bypass the liver, what's called the first pass hepatic metabolism. And in this conference, our formulation scientists, both within Tonix and also an important outside contract partner, presented data about the formulation.
Yeah, and Dr. Lederman, we should you mentioned that you're applying for that designation from the FDA, and this is after it's been heavily studied as well. You've done a number of clinical studies on this, and I'm sure that was brought up during this conference as well.
Yes, although this conference was mostly focused on the formulation science, in one of the oral presentations, one of our scientists was invited to do an oral presentation, and he went through some of the clinical trial results. And we expect TNX-102 SL to be, if approved, it would be the first new drug approved for fibromyalgia in more than 15 years. And since we've guided that we expect to file the new drug application in October, then we would expect a decision on FDA approval in 2025.
Okay. And lastly, just on the uses for this, I know you've talked about it in the past in interviews that we've done, just about the need for this. And as you mentioned, it's been quite a while since a new fibromyalgia drug has been available. So there is a greater need for what you're talking about.
Yes, fibromyalgia patients this is based on literature and some work that we've commissioned that we've discussed before. For example, a report by a consulting firm called Eversana has found that there is dissatisfaction among patients, even though there are three FDA-approved medicines for fibromyalgia. The side effects limit their use, and all drugs are, risk reward benefit of benefit versus side effect. So we've now have two statistically significant phase three studies supporting the approval of our drug. And in those studies, we have found our product to be well tolerated, an activity in fibromyalgia that we think should be sufficient for a decision by FDA.
All right. Well, we look forward to hearing more about that when the time is right. Dr. Lederman, thank you so much. Good update and good to see you as well.
Thank you.
All right. Dr. Seth Lederman, the CEO of Tonix Pharmaceuticals.